A new documentary is making a lot of us think about maybe getting rid of Facebook, Twitter, or Instagram altogether.
The social dilemma is raising the very question and shining a light on the dark side of social media. NBC2 investigator Evan Dean exposes some secrets that you may not have known about.
You can just get lost for like an hour. Just like sucks you in because it's like the next like thing that you see.
Ask yourself, how much time do you spend each day on social media?
I would say, yeah, I would use maybe a couple hours all in all.
Each day?
I think so, yeah.
Yep. Does that feel like too much?
Sometimes it does.
The Pew Research Center found more than 70% of U.S. adults use at least one social media site. It's way higher for teens. The average user spends between 2 to 3 hours per day on it. And yet, according to Pew, 64% of Americans say it has a mostly negative effect on the way things are going in the U.S. So what gives?
Social media is very addictive. If they didn't want you to constantly be on the platform, they wouldn't have notifications.
Tech expert Carrie Kursky has raised concerns about social media for a long time. Long before Netflix documentary The Social Dilemma did. Both warn of how much these sites know about us and what they do with it.
It's your likes, who you hang out with, what are your interests, what are your hobbies. This information is extremely valuable. If they're not selling a product, they're selling you, your information.
Guess how many social media sites I'm on? Zero.
FGCU's Elise Bartley says people should take a step back. Ask if your time spent on social media is healthy or productive, or even real.
Am I posting my children looking perfect because they're perfect, or do I want people to perceive them being perfect? You know, what's the goal of it?
It's hard for kids when they're at those younger ages to determine what's real and what's not. So they're getting these false expectations of what they're supposed to look like, act like, and wear, and what they're supposed to do.
Another major concern, in a time of political polarization, is how social media only adds to it. It often allows misinformation to spread like wildfire and can wedge a deeper divide in America.
It's just gotten pretty toxic recently. That's pretty much all there is to it. I don't really have anything to gain from it.
So every time you click on you like something or you share something, it's marking that check in the box in your profile saying, oh, these are things that they're interested in. And so it only sends you those. So there could be a whole nother view and a viewpoint and a whole nother opinion out there that you're never going to see because it's only feeding you what you like to see.
For the NBC2 investigators, I'm Evan Dean.